Tech Gadget TV.
What we can learn about the future of robotics from the Osimo period. Osimo, Advanced Step and Innovative Mobility, was once the most well-known advanced humanoid robot in the world. However, the abbreviation was taken from the Japanese word Osi, which means foot or leg. Osimo even played football with the President of the United States. At a running pace of 9 kilometers per hour, it would have been more difficult to outrun Zizou or bend it like Beckham. Honda's bipedal humanoid robot, on the other hand, was a charming innovation that held a lot of potential. It had a hefty price tag of $2.5 million in the realm of robots built for assisted living. But why did Honda put a halt to production? Throughout the 1980s, Honda experimented with the concept of prototype humanoids. A dozen prototypes were created during the next two decades. Honda debuted their first prototype humanoid, the P1, in 1993, a hefty machine with a height of 190 centimeters and a weight of roughly 175 kilograms. Finally, in 2000, the Osimo was released, and it quickly became known for its human-like mobility. It was honored into Carnegie Mellon's Robot Hall of Fame as the first robot to display such abilities not long after that. An all-new Osimo was released in November 2011 with an upgraded design and a 1-hour battery life. As a result, in June 2018, all production was halted. What could Osimo possibly do? With the use of sensors, it could understand spoken orders, human gestures, and navigate around human environments. It would have been a strong contender for the DARPA Robotics Challenge, but Honda could have done without it. They were well aware that their robot was exceptional. It was capable of recognizing a wide range of moving objects and faces. Osimo was 130 centimeters tall and weighed 48 kilograms in 2011. It was built at this height to accommodate anyone in a wheelchair. The Osimo was built for a variety of purposes. Also, it must have elicited public pity when it collapsed while attempting to walk up a flight of steps. I believe that Osimo's notoriety brought robotics to the public's attention. Honda employees also considered developing a humanoid robot that could move and walk like a human. That is exactly what they did. How important was Osimo to Honda's present strategy? Honda put a lot of effort into the research for Osimo. From 1986 through 2011, they continued to develop and test. Osimo was able to perform all of the difficult tasks, including hopping on one foot, climbing stairs, and running. To say that Osimo is currently a little behind the pack is an understatement. Boston Dynamics has delivered humanoid robots with talents that Osimo will not be able to match anytime soon. Osimo was, without a doubt, a valuable chance for Honda to showcase its robotics brand. But it was a long-term commitment, and they had to stick to it if they wanted to give their robotics division greater attention. And with a shift in their strategy, they might be able to do this. What was Honda's decision regarding Osimo? It was a choice between continuing to create new generations of Osimo and failing numerous times. Or do you accept the truth that robots' technologies provide a more realistic solution? Osimo was a remarkable feat in humanoid robotics, although it was purely for show. And getting ready for demos required a lot of time. A 2-minute demo, for example, would take around 6 months to prepare. As a result, Honda determined that Osimo's technology might be improved. Osimo's future in robotics. They'd been making the transition since July 2013, when they were working on an Osimo-based disaster response robot. Even though Osimo foretold the robot's future, he was not practical enough in and of himself. Osimo accomplished several impressive feats, but robotics is now about moving away from latency and toward actual capabilities. And Honda recognizes that Osimo's technology may be used for the greater good of humanity, not only for brand value. The technology created for Osimo would later be applied to considerably more practical applications in nursing and transportation. Honda would then concentrate on developing new robots. There were, however, a number of aspects of the Osimo robot that stood out. The technology created for Osimo would later be applied to considerably more practical applications in nursing and transportation. Honda would then concentrate on developing new robots. The Osimo robot, on the other hand, had a number of attributes that would serve as a model for future improvements. For the time being, the Osimo has been put on hold.